My name is Purit Pukhayapon. You can call me Ern. I'm the satellite lead at New Space Advanced Technology, and I work on the satellite system development and production. So basically, it's the path loss and the flexibility that the LEO satellites provide better than the GEO. GEO is better in terms of the geographic location, because GEO satellites frankly stay at the same point if you look into the perspective of the Earth. But in LEO, your satellite is much closer to the surface, so you got less loss here. And then another point is that when you have a LEO satellite orbiting around the Earth, you have a multiple satellite orbiting the Earth, and that would give you the flexibility in terms of the geographic area. So instead of one large satellite constraining a single position on the Earth, you would have a much smaller but a very large number of satellites orbiting the Earth, so that you can get the whole global coverage. So MUTE B200 is the first block of the Space IDC constellation development. We will try to do a constellation model later on, but the MUTE B200 is the first satellite block that we developed to gain, first off, the flight heritage and also any heritage associated with its subsystems. And also it gives us the opportunity to expand on the commercial module, so that we can get to know the commercial communication and data payloads that we may host for other people as well. We mainly focus on the power system since day one. We saw that in a higher frequency band that the broadband constellation is going towards, it requires a lot of more power, because in higher frequency you have a higher loss. Another point is that when you're changing from a communication payload to a data payload, for example a server computers, so that you can have the capability in edge computing in space, you would need a lot of power to cool down and to power your computing devices. Currently, we require about 30 to 40 people working with our team, both directly with the satellite or indirectly in the production or the power system or other subsystems or some components associated with it. We require about 6 months from the finalize of the design. We have already the bus systems, but we need to incorporate the payload into the bus system, and after we finalize that, it will take about more or less about 6 months from the start of the production. We need a bit of time to work on the power systems to ensure that our components and our systems are up to spec, and to qualify and accept the system and deliver that to the customer or the end users. So since last year, we have been developing the flight model of the first flight test for the MUTE B200 or the Block 1. We already finalized a lot of designs and are in production, and then in February we would like to verify the performance and also moving forward for protocolification of the system towards the flight test. So basically we would like to verify whether all the subsystem or the components are working together to function properly for the bus, and also serve to the payload the operation that it needs, mainly the power system that we will require it to function properly in variety of environment. There will be fluctuations of solar inputs, and we will need to confirm the battery packs and the power systems that it can manage itself. We would have to verify the communication links. If we actually send the satellite up in space, it can communicate with us on Earth. And frankly, if it can't do that, it would be a catastrophe. Another point that is very important is the attitude control. And we would need to verify if the satellite can point to a particular point on the Earth, so that we can actually align the antenna and other systems that we'll need to look at a specific part on the Earth. And the detumbling and pointing would be necessary to be verified on. So for the ground test, So as I said, we would like to verify the performance and the functionality from all aspects of the concept of operations, from processing with the launch vehicle up until the disposal of the mission. So we would need to verify if the flight software and hardware, everything work together in a harmony that can operate each of the phase of the mission properly. And after we can verify that, I think we can also, we expect these performance to be benchmarked so that we know what to be improved for the next version and for the next block as well. Yeah, so the block one is a sort of a single or a batch version, meaning that we're not really focusing the design on the mass production. We have in mind of the subsystem itself, but the component, the architecture of the satellite is not really around the mass production. So the block two would address that. First off, it would address the standardization of the components within. We will need to be able to incorporate many kinds of components of the satellites and also the payload as well, because frankly we would like to be able to use a more versatile sort of payload that people already use here on Earth. So we will need to find a standard that can accommodate that, and that would lead us to the block 2 development that would focus on not only the high power system that we already been developing with the block 1, but also the mass production and also some special features that we may add to as well. Yeah, so as you see the block 1 and block 2, when you have a lot of systems and that doesn't really have a standard per se from today, we need to be able to sort of customize that and be able to optimize that towards the size and the constraint, all the constraints that we have. And having the vertical integration capability in-house, we will be able to customize each component to its maximize its optimum design and also the production that we require for the constellation model. After that, I think we can improve upon each of the components technology. When we do the vertical integration, we see a lot of pain points in development of each of the components. For example, the reaction wheel, we see the problems in terms of the measurement. If we can't really quantify or verify its mechanical property, we can't really be sure about its accuracy. So being able to know that fact gives us more option in terms of future development, and that would be the fundamentals forward of the Block 2, Block 3, and essentially for other spacecraft as well. I think last couple of years ago, New Space has been engaging with suborbital launches, and we experimented with electronics payload or scientific payloads. We work with several organizations around Thailand, and we gain much experience on working with the space mission. You need to be able to integrate that in a timely manner, and that will require your advanced working environment. So that what we are working on today is really what we need 1 month or 6 months from now, and that for test flights really gives us that kind of sense of work side that we need our team to develop. And that sets also the work environment and also equipment that we need. This stuff that we have here, we will be able to integrate a space mission if we have this equipment in-house. And for the four flights that we had before, we didn't have that equipment before, so we needed to find it on the spot. And having that experience, it gave us a more sense to what kind of things that we need in place in order to make that happen in a timely manner.